Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zollotech, and iOS 16 Beta 8 and iOS 16 Public Beta 6 have been out for a few days. I've been using it full time, and many of you have based off the YouTube community poll, where at the time of this video there's 11,000 plus votes and over 140 comments. I've used all of those comments to determine what it's like overall to use this on not only my device, but your devices and iPads as well. So we'll talk about all of that a little bit later, but there's a few more features I wanted to mention this time around. Now, the first thing is not necessarily a new feature with beta 8, but the battery percentage. Many people keep asking me if this is a bug, and as you can see, this phone has 72%. And the battery does not deplete as far as the overall graphic as the battery goes down until it hits 20% or low power. So I let the iPhone X run down, and as you can see, it's down to 20%. If I change the wallpaper, it's a little easier to see this. So if I go over to this wallpaper, you'll see it's now got the little red icon and it's 20%. So for whatever reason, they decided not to change this until it's down to 20%. I wish it was animated, but maybe they did that to maybe save some battery or some power or something else. So it's not really a bug. I think that's the intended way it's supposed to be, but many people have been asking me about that, so I thought I'd bring it up. Now, the one change with iOS 16 Beta 8 that I actually missed in the initial What's New video is if you go to Software Update, it now says iOS 16.0. Before this, it just said 16.0. So it's a slight change, something they've made an update to. Not really anything huge, but I wanted to mention it. Now, also, if we go into Photos, you'll see here that I took a screenshot where it said device added to your account. Now the message itself is not necessarily new, but it showed up differently for me on this lock screen. So it says a Mac has now added or now has access to iMessage and FaceTime. If you don't recognize this device, you can remove it in settings. Before it would just pop up on your screen like this. This is the first time I've seen it, and I saw it over and over in notifications. So let me know if you're actually seeing that as well. Now, if we go into the Maps app, and if we search for a store that has a gas station, it will say pricing. This may have been here a couple betas ago, but if you tap on pricing, it opens up in a different app and shows you the actual price of gas at that location, or petrol, depending on what country you're in. So $3.21 per gallon, and it was updated yesterday on September 1st. Premium is $3.84. So that's something that's different that they've added. Of course, that's part of iOS 16 as a whole, but just wanted to make you aware of that. Also, iPhone 14 is rumored to have an always-on display, and within wallpapers, there's a couple different multi-layer wallpapers that you can sort of see that with here with a bug. Now, they should be able to bring it to iPhone 13, but whether or not they do that is hard to say. So if we switch over to those wallpapers, and we'll just change this to Do Not Disturb, we'll switch over to the iOS 16 stock wallpaper. This also works with the Six Colors wallpaper, and also the clownfish wallpaper that's from the older device. The way you get this to work, or sort of as a bug, what you can do is turn off the lock screen or turn it off, tap the lock screen and swipe up. So let's see if we can get this. It's hard for me to get this to work most of the time. Let's try it again. So we'll tap, swipe up. Let's try it again. We lock, tap, swipe up. And I can't get it to work 100% of the time, but sometimes it's a bit of a bug and it will go dark. And I'll show you exactly what that looks like. And a thanks again to Steve Mosier for pointing this out. And you'll see here, if we go back, he shows the three different wallpapers where they sort of have a multi-layered setup to them that has different brightness levels. So you can see that on all three wallpaper here. To do that, technically what you do is lock it and then just tap and then slide quickly. I can reproduce it sometimes, not all the time. Now, one feature that comes with iOS 16 that we really haven't been able to try very much is Passkey. This now works on a certain website. And so if we go to Safari, and then you'll see here under Account Security, you can go down to Face and Fingerprint Sign-In. So this is something we can try, and it says Setup on this device. You won't need a password. So we'll go ahead and hit Setup, and then we'll hit Continue. And now it's going to use Face ID and then log me in. It says you're all set. Face recognition or fingerprint sign-in is set up on this device. So now if we hit continue, and then if we go to sign back in, we can sign in with web authorization. You'll see here with your fingerprint. And then you'll see, do you want to sign into Best Buy with your saved passkey? And then it gives my email address. We'll hit continue. It wants Face ID. It says done and then signs me in. So this is something that's working. This is going to be great across the web where we'll no longer need to change our password regularly. It will just be stored in a passkey. It makes it much, much easier. So that's something you can try out on Best Buy. Now, one thing I wanted to mention as people keep asking is iOS 16 beta 8 may fix that issue with the security flaw that Apple updated for the kernel and for WebKit of Safari with iOS 15.6.1. We don't know if it's in iOS 16 yet. Apple has not confirmed it. They haven't said that it is. They haven't said that it isn't. So at this point, since this came out afterward, I would expect it to be in here, but if it's not, it will definitely be there with the final release of iOS 16. They still haven't updated their notes yet in the feedback app for some reason. So if we go back to the feedback app, wherever that went on my device, and we'll go here, go to feedback. If we go into feedback, you'll see here, if we go to the inbox, they still have the notes for beta 7. They haven't updated it yet for beta 8 for some reason. So for some reason, it's just not there. Now, the other day, Apple released iOS 12.5.6. I did a separate video on this. It's addressing that same security patch that they had with iOS 15.6.1. So now we have 12.5.6 supporting all the way back to the iPhone 6 or iPhone 12 compatible devices. So 6, 6 Plus, iPad Air, iPad Mini 3, certain devices that can still get iOS 12. So it's great to see Apple is still updating that. However, many are wondering if we're going to see an iOS 15.6.2 or iOS 15.7. And if we do, I would expect it maybe this coming week around the Apple event. We'll talk more about that a little bit later, but basically that's what I would really expect. Maybe a small update for that. Last year we had iOS 14.8. It's possible we won't have one this year and 15.6.1 will be the end of iOS 15, but I would expect at least another security patch. I wouldn't expect another big feature patch like iOS 14.8. I don't know that it needs a 0.8 update, but maybe we'll see one. We'll know as soon as next week, I would think. If not, we'll wait for iOS 16. So how is iOS 16 beta 8 versus iOS 16 beta 7? Well, iOS 16 beta 8 versus beta 7, or even versus 15.6.1, has a little ways to go. iPhone wouldn't really wake when tapping for me before. I had that bug earlier today. I would tap it. It wouldn't wake up. Sometimes that would happen. Sometimes it wouldn't. So there's still some odd issues here. Others are having contacts change or just have them go missing. So if you're using the contacts app and you'll see it's having problems unlocking, if you're using the contacts app and maybe you're searching for a contact, sometimes they're just not there and then they would return. I've had a couple people message me that are having this problem. So names could change from capital to lowercase or just missing altogether. That's obviously a major problem. So definitely report that one before the final release. Safari is locking up for some people. When playing music and driving, sometimes I was having an issue. So I'm playing music and then all of a sudden it would say I have no connection, even though I might have one or two bars. So that's an odd bug for me. This is the first time I'm seeing that. And that's something that's definitely problematic if you're downloading an album. Also on the lock screen, so maybe you're playing music. So we'll turn the volume down here, hit play. Maybe you've got the widget going, and if you tap on the album, this does not seem like the intended sort of interaction you would expect from Apple. I thought maybe it was on purpose, and then they would just get the timing correct, where it pops out, tap it, and it would pop in. But it's not timed properly, so it doesn't look right. So hopefully they fix that before the final update. You'll see it looks kind of odd, and why they're still having this issue with the music widget and overall album cover and art is odd. I also liked when it was expanded a little bit further where it sort of was more edge to edge. They shrunk it again with these betas, so I wish they would fix that. Also, ESPN Landscape has an issue, but that's more of an app issue for ESPN. That's because these apps are not updated yet for iOS 16. So we're waiting for overall compatibility for iOS 16 with many apps, including banking apps. Some apps just don't work, and that's because Apple doesn't necessarily allow them to update with iOS 16 changes. So things like live activities on the lock screen or things such as different widgets, they're not allowed yet for iOS 15. Once they allow that, usually after the release candidate or closer to the final release, we'll get a ton of different app store updates that will fix all of those issues, and then compatibility will return. So if you're concerned about that, that could be an issue for many people. Overall connectivity and phone calls seem to be okay for me. Some people are having issues with Wi-Fi. not just connecting, just disconnecting, acting a little weird. And I've heard many people say that resetting those settings under general, going down and then going to transfer or reset phone, going to reset, and then resetting network settings seems to fix that. Although you may have to sign back into every network. So just be aware if you try that. But typically that fixed an issue I had with it last year. It definitely will fix issues this year for many people as well. And so that leads me to, should you install iOS 16 betas? And at this point, if you're wanting to try them out, some people are having a better experience than iOS 15.6.1. Some are having a worse experience. So we're only a couple of weeks away from the final release. So if you want to try it out, you could try it out now, or maybe just wait until after the Apple event on September 7th, where they'll show off the new iPhone, new Apple Watches. So iPhone 14, iPhone 14 Plus is what we think the name will be, 14 Pro and 14 Pro Max on the 7th with new Apple Watch Series 8. We're waiting for all of those. And then after that event, Apple will typically release the release candidate. So we should have iOS 16 release candidate and then the final release, usually the following Monday. That's typically what they do. So I would wait for the release candidate if you haven't tried them yet. If you're on beta 7, definitely update. If you're on public beta 5, definitely update. Otherwise, maybe just wait until the release candidate, as the release candidate is typically the final release. Now, as far as overall battery life, this varies greatly from person to person. Some people have said they've had the same battery life as iOS 15. Some have had better, some have had worse. So it really depends on the person and most likely the apps they're using. If we go into battery health, you'll see I'm at 98%. Pretty typical a year later, that's not an issue. 80% after 2 years is normal according to Apple. So if it's lower than 98%, that's fine. I wouldn't worry about it. It will tell you when it needs to be replaced as far as the battery goes. Over the last 10 days, and you'll see it seems like I might have a touch issue there. Yesterday, I had 2 hours and 36 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 30 minutes of screen off time, and used about 50% of my battery. That's not very good overall. Today, a little bit better at 25% usage with 2 hours and 14 minutes. So it's okay depending on day to day. You'll see today I used mostly the home and lock screen with the sort of notifications and more. Mail definitely is having some issues, and it says connected to charger, it used 11%. So there's sort of a new message there letting me know that when it was connected to the charger, it used 11% of the battery. That's kind of a new message I hadn't seen before. And so overall, battery is okay. I would expect it to get a little bit better once the release candidate is out. As far as overall heat, my phone has stayed nice and cool. Now, I don't play a lot of games on this, but if you do, it will warm up. That's pretty typical, but so far it's nice and cool. And let me show you that. So as you can see with the FLIR thermal camera, at the hottest point, it's about 86 degrees Fahrenheit. That's what I would expect. That's pretty typical. It's a little bit warmer than overall room temperature. And you'll see the phone next to it with the screen on is at 87 to 88 degrees Fahrenheit. That's pretty normal and what you can expect. As far as iPadOS 16.1, well, this has been out for over a week. Apple did not release a new beta for this. And so it seems to be okay so far. It's an early beta of 16.1, but I haven't had any app crashes. ProMotion is nice and smooth. And if we go into settings, go down to battery, battery life overall seems to be pretty good. So yesterday, 2 hours and 23 minutes, and it was charged to 100%. So since then, I've used it 2.5 hours and then another 48 minutes or so. So 3 hours, we're down to 55%. I'm getting about 5 to 6 hours of screen on time with this device. That's typical at this point. I really haven't seen it improve since I had it new. The battery health is pretty good overall, but I haven't seen the 10 hours of battery life typical of what you get when you get this new. However, usually 9 to 10 hours is normal. I'm getting 5 to 6. Now, overall performance is quite good. Like I mentioned on the iPad, ProMotion is nice and smooth on the newer devices. No issues there. Going into music, going into different apps is nice and fast, as you would expect, even on older devices. And I did want to run a little test with the iPhone 10, and despite having, well, 19%, I thought it was at 20, but 19% battery life. If we go into Real Racing 3, you'll see it resumes, which is nice. I opened this before I started filming this video, so that's pretty good. We'll hit resume, and it seems to be nice and smooth. Now, when I first opened this game, it was a little bit laggy. So it seems like it's resuming okay here, but overall performance is quite good, even on older devices. So I don't think Apple's slowing anything down. The only time you could expect that is maybe if you had poor battery health and you needed to replace the battery. And this is at 88%, and it's still working just fine. Now, as far as the YouTube community poll and some of your comments, let's take a look at that. So if we go into YouTube, you'll see at the time of this video, we have over 11,000 votes and 141 comments. Let me refresh here, and it's still the same. And you'll see here at the time of this video, 32% of you are saying it's great. Still again, 3% think it's terrible. 12% say it's okay, but still have some bugs. 47% haven't upgraded yet, and 6% are on Android. That seems to be pretty typical from week to week. 3% saying it's terrible, although less people saying it has some bugs, but we're still about half of the votes away from last week. Now let's take a look at some of your comments. Stendy says, I'm using iOS 16 public beta 6 on my iPhone 12. So far it's been very stable. I've not had any bugs or app crashes. Performance has been 100% and my battery life is good as it was on iOS 15.6.1. I'm getting a full day of normal use for me without any problems or drain. 1010 would recommend if you're on the fence about installing it. Estrella says, public beta 6 has been solid for me on an iPhone SE 2. No real bugs so far, except my notifications overlapping an album when I'm listening to a song on the music app. It also jiggles the playing platter when I exit. This one is still here. I'm not really sure if this is intentional or not, but it's something worth mentioning as I might report it to Apple once more because it does feel kinda off. It's an odd behavior for sure. Battery life seems to be pretty good as it was on previous betas. At least I haven't noticed a drop on it yet. Looking forward to your next video. Have a great day. David Rice says, I'm on public beta 6 on my iPhone 13 Pro Max and it's been great. I've had one issue where I completely lost signal in an area where I usually get good 5G UC, but that could have been my network maintenance that day and I haven't had that problem since. I do also have occasional hiccups with the keyboard not coming up while I'm in iMessage. It's usually after sending a picture. Federico said, compared to my experience on iOS 15 beta 8 last year, iOS 16 beta 8 is nearly perfect. Battery life is improving quite substantially. I can now get more than 6 hours of screen on time and performance is good. Can't wait to see what's next in terms of software. iPhone XR. Now there were some people that said they had poor battery life, but most people are saying that it's a better experience than last time. So this is a good sign. It looks like it's better. In fact, I've heard from someone that's quite particular on battery that they went to iOS 15.6.1, they downgraded and have worse battery life than they did with beta 7 or beta 8. So it looks like they're going to upgrade again. But overall, some people will still have bugs, and if you do, make sure you report those in the feedback app. Of course, if you found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, we're looking for that Apple event in just a few days. So let me know if you'd like to hear more about that event, a different video, or something else. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, it'll be linked in the description as it always is. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.